I mean, with artificial intelligence, we are summoning the demon.
Summoning the demon.
It's kind of a loaded statement because he fails to mention that nuclear weapons or hydrogen bombs may or may not in fact be real. Lunar Light Entertainment proudly presents
Skynet. A computer program designed to automate missile defense.
I need to know how Skynet gets built.
If we uplink now, Skynet will be in control of your military.
We have to shut down Skynet.
Will you please stop saying Skynet?
All right, everyone. Frank Monday with Lunar Light Entertainment. This is going to be my first ever attempt, guys, at debunking a video. Just doing some overall commentary. I pulled this one from a user that had obviously pulled it from other sources. So it's concerning Elon Musk, and let's just react. So reaction video, my first ever reaction video. Here we go, about Elon Musk and the future coming AI.
And a warning from Tesla Motors CEO Elon Musk. It has nothing to do with cars. Instead, Musk warns about artificial intelligence, which he has called more dangerous than nuclear weapon. Musk spoke at a symposium at MIT.
And a warning from Frank Monday, and it has nothing to do with reality. It's total fantasy. He warned that the hype about the coming AI is totally ridiculous.
I mean, with artificial intelligence, we are summoning the demon.
Summoning the demon. Summoning.
I'd like to preface this by stating that Lunar Light Entertainment does not support the views and opinions of anyone featured in any of their videos. This is just pure opinion by Frank Monday, fantasy straight out of his noggin. All right. Let's get into this motherfucker and see what's happening.
Now, what's your take on where we are in the AI race just now?
Wow, that's a long answer. AI hardware, the computers coming online that are dedicated to AI, that is increasing what looks like at least by a factor of 10 every year, if not every 6 to 9 months. So when you combine the hardware coming online, really order of magnitude increase every, call it at least every 9 months, and many, many software breakthroughs.
One thing right off that you guys got to take into consideration when you listen to Elon Musk make predictions about anything. He's the man that in like 2012 told us that by 2016 we would be on Mars, right? He's building a spaceship and we're going to do a mission to Mars by 2018. Obama backed him up on that. So when he launched his Tesla car, he said that all driving would be automated within a year or two. And it's been like, 12 years since he said that. So anything you say about anything he says, Elon Musk, especially about the progressive development of these technologies emerging into the public, need to be taken with like a spoonful of salt.
If you look at that curve, it looks insane. So I think my guess is that we'll have AI that is smarter than any one human, probably around the end of next year. And then AI, the total amount of sort of sentient compute of AI, I think will probably exceed all humans in 5 years.
What is the race about just now? Is it algorithms? Is it people? Is it computing power? What is it about just now? Is it the supply of chips? What is it?
Yeah, last year it was chip constrained. And the hardware deployment, to break it down into the three areas of people, data, and hardware, starting with hardware. Last year it was about a chip supply. People could not get enough NVIDIA chips particularly. This year it's starting to transition to a voltage transformer supply. So just actually getting enough voltage transformers put in place. So my sort of very niche joke is transformers for transformers, because a lot of the AI that's run is called a transformer. You need transformers to run transformers. And then next, if you look out a year or two, or certainly 3 years, it's just electricity availability. So those are the constraints on the hardware side. So many of the world's smartest people are doing AI. People that would have done physics before, in fact, or have done physics, for example, have moved into AI because it's just the fastest moving field. So we're seeing a lot of the best talents, a lot of the smartest humans going into AI. And then we see, along with that, algorithmic breakthroughs. And then you start hitting the wall with the data problem. So you can fit all books ever written, just the text, the text in compressed form on one hard drive, or we'll call it one computer. So when you're looking at like tokens to train on, because you can still give like all the books ever written in all languages by all humans, sounds like a lot. Certainly, it's far more than any one human could ever read. It actually is a small number. It's a small number of training tokens. It's just not enough. So then you start having to look at all the videos ever created. You know, all the podcasts, all the everything, and you start even running out of data there.
All right, so let's just tackle some of what he said from right here in the bathroom. And keep in mind, his predictions are routinely decades off. So first off, he said that AI is going to be smarter than people. Now, number one, AI is just whatever people program it to be. It's just a set of programs. If he's saying that these algorithms will be able to program each other to be smarter and stuff like that in the future, they could program themselves to take over the world, that's inferring a lot. That's saying that there's consciousness there, which there isn't, or that there's decision-making power. So you can't. It doesn't want to mean by to be smarter than people. It's what we've seen from AI right now is not indicative of that. The first step, he says, people are going to be surpassed by AI. Again, these are just tools that serve people. So I don't know how this really makes logical sense or that it's reasonable. What about the hardware part? You know, he says the hardware is getting there and that we're going to have the chips and processors and stuff like that. But what is hardware? It's just crap that's hooked up to electronics. And then if any of that burns out, it's all fallible to such an extent. It's far more fallible than the human mind itself. I mean, how long does your average microchip last? Maybe it lasts a long time, but the human brain and its interaction with the prime material plane lasts, could be anywhere from 50 to 100 years, right? Whereas these chips are being surpassed and replaced, I don't know, do they last a decade? My laptop has lasted about a decade. I mean, obviously these big servers are going to be different, but then the power thing. So who's going to allocate the power? Who's going to pay for it? Why would that power be allocated to certain systems that may or may not serve humanity? All of those are decisions that have to be made by the human realm. Now, I assumed that in 2020, actually AI had already been installed, and that people in general, their decision-making process had been usurped. It might have even been much earlier than that, but that was my suspicion.
What's the biggest challenge you have with XAI?
Well, XAI is still relatively new, so it's not, you know, like the limiting factor right now is just training our Grok version 2 model, which should be, we think, better than GPT-4, and that's, we're hoping to complete that in May. So that's training right now. So it's just really, we're just trying to get enough GPUs online to train it fast enough to get that done in May, which I think probably will happen. And then, and that's with roughly 20,000 H100s and doing, I think, very efficient training. Then the next step would be for Grok 3, which would be, I guess, GPT-5 or beyond, would, you know, requires 100,000 NVIDIA H100s training coherently. So that's, you know, a half order of magnitude, basically, more training. And then you really start to have running into this data problem where you have to either create synthetic data or use real-world video. Those are the two sources of kind of like unlimited data, synthetic data and real-world video.
So that's if and when they build 20,000 NVIDIA H100s, is that what they were called, or 100,000 of them? The prediction that's on that, I mean, anything could go wrong with any of these systems. They're not taking these kinds of things into consideration. He never does. He just pie-in-the-sky type of predictions. And there's so many random factors that everything would have to align perfectly within, what do you say, 5 years, which probably people can't get it together for the next 3 or 4 decades, if then.
Which I should say, Tesla has a pretty big advantage in real-world video. Tesla has by far the most real-world video of anyone.
Yeah, you've got a huge library there. So when do you think we'll see proper AGI?
Well, it depends on how you define AGI. If you define AGI as smarter than the smartest human, I think it's probably end of next year, like within 2 years. But that's that. There's still a pretty big leap beyond that to say smarter than the machine augmented human collective. So like, is it smarter than all humans working together who are also using computers to augment their output? And that I think is probably 5 years away. One way to look at it is to try to assess like roughly what is the ratio of digital to biological compute. And so biological computer, all the human brains that are thinking.
Last question on AI. Any new thoughts on regulation and how it should be structured?
Well, I think we probably do need some sort of regulatory authority to look at the safety of AI, just as we have regulatory authorities in other arenas to oversee aircraft and the safety of aircraft and cars and other things, medication. So the rate at which AI is progressing is faster than probably any regulatory agency can keep up with. But I do have a comment on what I think is very important for achieving safe AI, which is that it's very important to train the AI to be as truthful as possible and not to, just to be as truthful as possible. I think you can get some very dangerous things.
Dude, doesn't even sound like a real correct. Human being. He sounds like some guy struggling on the verge of stroke. Now, so how much really credit should we put into his words?
AI has immense power. You can take the Google Gemini example where it refused to produce a picture of George Washington as a white man. And any historical figure would automatically be made diverse because it's been programmed to insist on diversity, which sounds, perhaps okay at first. But
this just goes to show what ludicracy they're producing and how ridiculous their systems are. Really, need we have any kind of fear over the morons that are putting this kind of shit together?
Until the diversity number is what is programmed to believe is correct.
But do you think this will be sorted out in the next version?
No.
You don't think so?
I'd just like to finish off with a few comments about what he said concerning training the AGI, that they were going to need access to the world's entire library of books, publications, and all of that. Now, even with what Google has done, which is just a fraction of the books created by humanity, they're not online, they're not available. Tesla's probably going to have some premium access to those types of archives, but it's just not there. It hasn't all been cataloged. And even the internet isn't a totally interconnected system anymore. Google's the ultimate gate guard when it comes to the U.S. system of the internet. And then Baidu is the gate guard for the Chinese one. So these systems aren't even going to be able to have direct access to the entire expanse of the internet to do the training. They'll be limited to what they can purchase and have the right to. So many factors went into what he said, like the video, so he can use Tesla's video, but he'll only be able to use Tesla's video. He won't be able to use Google's unless he finds a way around it. And then you're predicting that there's going to be an AI that can do all of the hacking unimpeded by any type of organic system or any type of system that's already in place. I think it's a huge stretch in his imagination. But that's what, obviously a guy whose business is selling this stuff and hyping it up for the world, obviously he's going to go about a lot of hyperbole and just conjecture and make ridiculous statements that aren't probably ever going to come true.
Now, keep in mind, everyone, this is just one man's take on this type of thing. I might not know my ass from a hole in the ground, but I certainly know a charlatan businessman when I see one, and he's always been famous for that. So I'll see you on the next one. Into the abodes of the future. Keep doing good magic, guys, at Astra Peraspera.